chimeras are important, and understanding where they fit in the tree is important because they represent a valuable and unique archive of information on biodiversity. And it's not only about their anatomy, it's also about what's in their genome. And the chimeras have long been most difficult to place deep in the tree of life because they're so highly specialized. Their anatomy is quite unlike the other members of the cartilaginous fishes. They don't look much like sharks and rays. Their skull is especially difficult to understand relative to sharks and rays because it looks more like ourselves. Hence the name. The name Chimaera reflects this mythical beast from classical mythology. And this gets to the nub of the problem. The earliest fossil chimeras that we know about are about 340 million years old, and they look pretty much like modern chimeras. I asked a colleague in South Africa, Rob Guess, to have a look at a fossil shark, which is a bit odd, and I've been curious about for years. It was described in the 1980s, and he was going to the Cape Town Museum. I knew it was in the collections there, but whether he could find it again, and he did. He found it, and he got it scanned in South Africa. This is a nodule like the one containing the South African shark. I should stress the South African shark is still in South Africa and available for other scientists to look at in the Cape Town Museum. Now, we thought this was the skull of an unusual group of sharks that lived around 330 plus million years ago. Now, the surprise came when we first of all realized how complete the skull was, and it is beautifully preserved. When we looked inside it, because we can, with computer technology, virtually fill the skull and look at all the spaces occupied by the brain, by the canals of the inner ear, by the major cranial nerves and the nostrils, and we realized that within were the signatures of a chimera. So it's one of these early strange sharks on the outside, which we've always found difficult to place in the tree. And the key to this was looking on the inside. It was cryptically, if you like, a chimera on the inside. Now that we know who they evolved from, we can put a hard minimum date on their divergence from the rest of sharks. Now, this is important because chimeras have had their whole genome sequenced, and it's already apparent that they have a slowly evolving genome. But for all of these kinds of questions, in the interest and value of finding a very slowly evolving vertebrate genome, for the insight that gives us into our shared past.